Welcome back to Super Politics. We're doing a vote tally here. right now, we're doing a vote tally of what our guests tonight think is going to be the Senate impeachment trial vote. Joining us now in this segment is Attorney Harry Roque. Hi, Harry. Thank you for being here.
Always a pleasure, Pia.
Yeah, okay. Very briefly, although I know you already know what we're going to do, so we have this corkboard, this magical corkboard. One is no mercy, one comes with mercy. Then we're going to be tacking on the pictures based on your gut feel and your analysis of the situation or how these guys are going to be voting. And in random order, we have pictures of 22 senators. Of course, the there's a 23rd dapat. We're very sorry, Sonny Trillanes. But tao lang po kami. Hindi, tsaka wala kasing ano eh. Matagal na siyang nawala sa Senado. So anyway, let's start, Harry. Tito Soto, where should we put him?
Well, I put him in uncertain.
Uncertain, okay. Yung mga uncertain dito namin nilalagay sa baba. Manny Villar?
Uncertain.
Uncertain. Why uncertain?
Well, number one, I'm not really sure if we should read anything into the manner by which the son voted. The son abstained. An abstained vote is effectively a no vote, no? Mm-hmm. The ground, of course, is they have a relative in the Senate, but I don't buy that, no? Mm-hmm. An uncertain answer, an abstention is a no vote, so the son voted no, as far as I'm concerned.
Okay, but it's like a safer way of...
Yeah. Of saying no, because saying remember, no. Pia, we need here affirmative votes of conviction. Mm-hmm. If the senators do not appear, that's considered as a not conviction vote, mm-hmm. Okay. An acquittal vote. Okay. If they don't vote, it's an acquittal vote. So it has to be an affirmative guilty
Can the senators abstain?
They cannot abstain because the Constitution says it must be two-thirds of all the votes of the senators. No?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Miriam Santiago.
Definitely with mercy.
With mercy.
She has said so.
Migs Zubiri?
I think that she'll go with mercy.
Let's put Migs here. With mercy. Edgardo Angara?
Uncertain at most.
Uncertain.
But I would say he would lean towards with mercy.
Hmm. Okay. And uncertain because?
Well, I think he's choosing between abstaining or voting with mercy. Mm. But in my mind... the fact that you haven't heard really anything from Ed Angara on the ombudsperson means that he does not find her too objectionable.
Mm, okay. JPE, Senate President.
JPE will not be voting unless there's a tie. So
okay,
let's set
him
aside. Although I would say that if he were to vote, he would vote with mercy.
Okay. Let's put him down there. Marcos.
Definitely with mercy.
With mercy. Onasan.
Onasan will vote with Enrile. So wherever Enrile is, Onasan will be there.
Really? Jingoy?
He might vote with mercy. Mm-hmm. Although there's a hope that because the brother changed his mind from no to yes, he might also change. But I think right now, it's a with mercy and he will use the line that we should be trying Gloria Macapagal Arroyo first and not Merceditas Gutierrez.
Okay, but we will put him here. So
let's
with mercy.
In with mercy.
Oh, so in medyo conservative,
yes.
Conservative tayo ngayon, no? Compared to Dean Valdez and Inday's analysis. Cheese, Escudero.
Definitely no mercy.
You're sure of that, huh? Okay.
I think so. I mean, he's up for re-election in 2013. He can't afford not to vote for
the
impeachment.
And then there's 2016.
And then there's 2016. But 2016 is too long away. I think people will forget the voting in 2013. I mean, after ERAP,
did
people remember how the senators voted?
Yeah,
they did
not. So from 2011 to 2000, there's like four.
That's
four to
a lifetime ahead of us.
Okay. No? Ralph Rector.
Well, he would definitely with no mercy. He has to vote on party lines, although with him, you're never sure which party he's with, of course.
Francis Pangilinan.
Definitely no mercy.
Serge Osmeña.
Serge is an independent thinker, so put him in the uncertain. Mm-hmm. His pronouncement is he does not like the fact that the palace has been intervening with not only the House proceedings, but also with the Senate. So, and he's the type of person who definitely could say, I don't care, because anyway, he's not up for election.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Bong Revilla.
Definitely with mercy.
Frank Dulon.
Definitely no mercy.
T.G. Gingona.
No mercy.
Yeah, said so himself. Ping Lacson.
No mercy.
When or if he resurfaces.
It's important he surfaces, because if he doesn't vote, it's a vote for mercy.
Okay.
That is why they must make sure he is around when the voting occurs.
Pia Cayetano.
You know, I would say that Pia would be uncertain. Uncertain.
So
I think the Cayetano siblings will vote together with Manny Villar.
Okay, pero even Alan, uncertain.
I think he's uncertain as well. No?
Loren Legarda.
Loren Legarda normally votes with Ed Angara.
Mm-hmm.
So, but she is, however, up for election. So let's put her in the uncertain.
Okay. Joker Arroyo?
Definitely with Merci.
With Merci. Lito Lapid?
Definitely with Merci.
Okay. Oh, sorry. Ito na. Sunny Juliana. Sorry, pinahabol ko.
Definitely no Merci.
No Merci. Okay. So, as far as Attorney Harry Roque is concerned, let's count.
The sure numbers
sure
are
numbers.
Seven.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
in
six,
favor of
seven
no Merci.
And 2, 4. Seven also.
Seven also with Merci.
Pero ang daming uncertain, ha? Huh? 5, 6,
but
7.
But if
eight.
I'm correct, and I hope I'm not, because Pia, remember 2 years ago, I was the first one who publicly asked for the impeachment of Merceditas Gutierrez. No?
Mm-hmm.
If I'm correct, she's acquitted because all she needs is 7 votes.
Mm-hmm. So wait, how many needed for conviction? 16?
Well, 2/3, no?
Yeah, 23 sila ngayon. Eh.
23, so, if Ping Lacson does not show up, all she needs really is 7 votes.
Okay.
But if Ping Lacson does show up, then she would need 8 votes to be absolved. No?
Mm-hmm.
But right now, Ping Lacson is nowhere to be seen.
Mm-hmm.
The family of the Dasera and Corbito have both said that they will, in fact, file an appeal with the Supreme Court. So we don't know. I hope he comes out. I hope the worst is over for him.
Mm-hmm.
But knowing the minds of the lawyers of the other camp, I think they will try to.
Yeah. Okay, so
frustrate.
Merci needs 7 or 8 votes for an acquittal.
Definitely.
But you were saying kanina, pag hindi bumoto yung senador, that's practically a vote for her. No?
It's a vote
but
for her.
But is there such a thing as a senator who will not vote?
Well, if you want to be politically correct,
going to be?
You will say, I'm abstaining. Mm-hmm. But that has the effect of a vote for Merci. Because as I said, the conviction must be a positive, unequivocal conviction.
Yeah, okay. What's the effect of the vote of the House last night?
Well, the thing with the senators is I think they have proven themselves to be independent, no?
Mm-hmm.
And of course, in between now and the day of the judgment, there will be lots of horse trading. Let's face it, the senators are brilliant horse traders, so anything can happen, no?
Okay.
But as it stands, what I'm saying is the House prosecution team should, in fact, think that the voting pattern is like this right now and that they need to work double time.
Mm-hmm. Okay, final words, and in this part of the show, Inday Espina Verona rejoins us. So, Inday, given what you heard about what Dean Valdez was saying, he's 15 votes in the No Merci column, ano? Yung sayo, 16 votes ka.
With
15 plus Sunny Trillian, 16. Very, very confident kayo.
And Pollyanna, I think a lot of these people here, they both said, we're not sure.
Mm-hmm.
I think, however, some of them will be wanting a legacy. They want to be remembered for a certain way, and I think eventually they're going to go for No Merci.
Uh-huh. But of course, Harry also was saying, kasi na malayo din yung 2016, yung iba sa kanila wala namang plans for re-election or for running or for whatever.
I mean, remember, Pia, this is also a Senate that did not elect an LP as a Senate President.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And much as the LP members wanted Francis Pangilinan, they were not able to do so at the time when the president had unprecedented support. That support has somehow gone down a little. It's still very
but
high.
But it's 74. That's
it's still 74, but it has gone down from what it was, which was 80 plus.
Mm-hmm.
At the time when he wanted
was it low
Pangilinan
80s or
elected.
Or mid-80s, you remember?
It's pretty high, actually.
It was, I think, mid-80s. No, but at that time, he could have gotten anything that he would have wanted from the Senate. He failed in electing Francis as Senate President. So that's an indication of how the senators think, no?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they are nationally elected and they feel that they have a fair chance at the presidency and they will hold their position, no?
Okay.
Final, I'm just hoping that the Malacanang can, in fact, give them what they want, no, when horse trading comes.
Okay, final last words, 2 sentences, Inday.
Well, I'm an optimist forever, and I'm just going to say Filipinos out there had better raise their voices if they want, whether it's No Merci or with Merci. I think the senators will listen.
Thank you, Inday Espina Verona. Attorney Harry Walker?
Well, I think the senators, because they are politically astute, know that the people want Merci out.
Mm-hmm.
I hope they listen to the people, But then again, history has shown that it is not always the case that they do listen to the public clamor. Mm-hmm. I'm praying and hoping that they will, because we need to oust Merci. We need to restore accountability in our government.
Okay. Maraming salamat, Attorney Harry Roque and Inday Espina Barona, journalist and blogger. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Join us again next Tuesday. I'm your host, Beyond Tavares, making sure it's nothing personal. It's strictly politics. Thank you. Good night.